name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to measure the mass of the Alka-Seltzer tablets that we're going to use for our limiting reactant experiment. For this experiment, we're going to need 8 little cups. Because we're measuring mass, we're going to need a scale. I am going to use a pair of scissors to open up my Alka-Seltzer pouches, which means that I will need 8 Alka-Seltzer tablets, and if these come in packets of 2, then I will need 4 packets. I need to record all my masses for the tablets, and I already pre-prepared some sheets of paper on which I will record them separately for each experiment and for each tablet. And then finally, because I am recording data, I will be using a pen. So the first thing that I'm going to do is take my first cup and take my first piece of paper, write down experiment 1, and then turn on my scale. When it says 0.00, I will place my red cup on the scale, press tear, and when it shows 0.00, I will place the first tablet in it. Once placed, I will record the mass of the tablet, which in my case is 3.21 grams. For experiment 1 and cup 1, I'm going to make the connection by placing the cup on the piece of paper that is going to track everything that I'm going to do with this tablet. Next, I'm going to move on to experiment 2, place another cup on the scale, take my second sheet of paper and write experiment 2 on it. Then I will tear my scale and place the next Alka-Seltzer tablet inside. The masses will be relatively similar, so this one is also 3.21 grams. Once recorded, I will place my tablet in the cup on the piece of paper and move it to the side. On to experiment number 3. The most important part of this experiment is keeping track of all our measurements, and this is one of the best ways in which we can do this. So yes, it will take a little bit longer, but it will be worth it at the end. Place the cup on the scale, tear, and then open up a new pouch to extract your third tablet. If your tablet is broken, it's okay just to extract both pieces and place them together inside the cup. This one has a mass of 3.15 grams. For our fourth experiment, we're going to do the same exact thing. Let's not forget to tear every time we place a cup on the scale. Our fourth tablet weighs 3.26 grams. For experiment 5, we bring up our cup, place it on the scale, make sure that it's teared. Extract our next tablet and place it inside the cup. The mass of our tablet is 3.25 grams. For experiment 6, we place the cup on the scale, tear it, and then extract the 6th tablet. Its mass is 3.21 grams. For experiment 7, we open our final pouch. And record the mass of our tablet, which is also 3.23 grams. For our final experiment, experiment number 8, we're going to place a cup on the scale, tear, and place our final tablet inside the cup. Its mass is 3.23 grams. With all our tablets prepared, we have the first set of measurements for our limiting reactant experiment.